Pre-stressed membranes are used in a wide range of applications, from musical instruments to metamaterials. Hello, I'm Armin. In this video, I'll show you how to calculate the natural frequencies of a pre-stressed membrane. Before we start, I'd like to give a brief explanation about the model. A membrane is a thin and flexible surface placed under tension to enhance its structural stability and functional performance. It is widely used in various fields, including architectural structures, musical instruments, and acoustic metamaterials. Due to its minimal thickness, a membrane cannot resist bending moments and remains unstable without tension. Therefore, it must be pre-stressed to maintain its shape and effectively support mechanical or acoustic functions. The natural frequency of a pre-stressed circular membrane depends on the tensile force, diameter, density, and thickness. It is also related to the Bessel function. In this video, we calculate the natural frequencies of a circular membrane. To apply pre-stressing, we first use the static structural system. Then, we use the modal analysis system to compute the natural frequencies. The membrane is pre-stressed, so we need to stretch it before running any simulation. To do this, we'll perform a static structural analysis. I'll start by generating the geometry and space claim. So I'll right-click on Geometry and select New Space Claim Geometry. Since the membrane is circular, I'll choose the Circle tool from the Sketch tab and click at the origin. The diameter is set to 300 millimeters, so I'll type it in and press Enter. Then, click End Sketch Editing. Next, I'll define the membrane's thickness. I'll click on the surface from the structure tree, and in the thickness field, I'll enter 0.2 millimeters and press Enter. Everything looks correct so far. Now, we need two reference lines to apply boundary conditions properly. I'll enter sketch mode again, select the membrane surface, and click Plan View for a normal top-down view. Now, I'll select the Line tool and draw two perpendicular lines across the diameter of the circle. These lines will make it easier to apply the boundary conditions later. Press Escape, and then click End Sketch Editing. As you can see, it's still a single part, but the sketch lines have divided it into four quarters. We can now select each quarter individually if needed. Everything is ready. I'll now close Space Claim. Let's proceed with modeling by double-clicking on the model cell. Now, we're inside the model environment. First, I'll expand the geometry and click on the surface part. As you can see, the thickness was already defined in Space Claim, so we don't need to change it. The material is currently set to structural steel, and I'll keep it as is. The stiffness option is set to membrane and bending, indicating a shell formulation. You can change it to membrane only, but the results will remain the same. Since our membrane is circular, we need to use a cylindrical coordinate system to apply the edge loads for pre-stretching. To create that, I'll right-click on Coordinate Systems and choose Coordinate System at Center of Mass. Then, I'll change the coordinate type from Cartesian to cylindrical. Let's adjust the coordinate system by changing its axes to match the geometry properly. Everything looks good. In this setup, X corresponds to R, Y corresponds to Phi, and Z remains as Z. Now let's generate the default mesh to check the element size. The mesh looks too coarse, so I'll refine it. I'll change the element size to 0.01 meters, press Enter, and then regenerate mesh again. Now the element size looks much better. Next, We need to apply line pressure on the membrane's edges to stretch it. Right-click on Static Structural and select Line Pressure. Then, I'll choose all the edge lines. Now, click Apply. I'll change the definition from vector to component because I want to apply the pressure along a specific coordinate direction. I will also set the coordinate system to cylindrical. We want to apply a tension of 10,000 newton per meter in the radial direction, so I'll enter that value in the x direction. Now, let's constrain the membrane. I want to prevent any motion in the y direction, which corresponds to the out-of-plane displacement. Note that x refers to the radial direction in the cylindrical coordinate system, not the global coordinate system. So, I'll right-click on Static Structural and choose Displacement. Select Edge Selector, hold Control, and click all the edge lines. Now, hit Apply and set the Y displacement to 0. It's important to note that the line pressure and displacement constraints are compatible, ensuring that the model is not overconstrained. Next, we'll fix a point to prevent in-plane displacement. Right-click on Static Structural, select Fix Support, switch to Point Selector, pick a point on the edge, and hit Apply. Now, the membrane can still rotate around the y-axis, so we need one more constraint. Right-click again on Static Structural, choose Displacement, select another point, click Apply, and set the Z component to 0. Now the geometry is fully constrained in all directions and ready to solve. Right-click on Static Structural, select Solve, and wait for the solution to finish. The solution is complete. Now, we can check the stress in the membrane. I'll right-click on Solution, and from the Insert menu, select Von Mises Stress. Right-click on it, and choose Evaluate All Results. As you can see, the membrane stress is 50 megapascals uniformly across all regions. There are no artificial stress concentrations, since the geometry has no singular points. Now, we're ready to perform a modal analysis. I will close the model window and proceed with the simulation process. To calculate the natural frequencies, we need to insert a modal system. I'll drag and drop the modal analysis into the solution cell of the static structural analysis. This way, the static solution will be shared automatically with the modal setup. I'll double-click on Setup under the modal system. Everything looks good, but we still need to update the static structural analysis one more time. As you can see, pre-stress is enabled and receives data from the static structural analysis. This means we now have a pre-stressed modal analysis. Also, all boundary conditions have been automatically imported into the modal analysis setup, so there's no need to define them again. Now, right-click on Modal and select Solve. Once the solution is complete, we can ignore the warning message. It doesn't affect the results. Click on the Solution branch. You'll now see the list of natural frequencies. To visualize the mode shapes, click on an edge of the membrane, right-click, and select Create Mode Shape Results. Then, click Update to generate the corresponding mode shapes. Let's examine the mode shapes. The first natural frequency is approximately 204 Hz. I also calculated the analytical natural frequencies in Excel. The first natural frequency is 203 Hz. The second is 324 Hz. And the on-cease result for the second frequency is 326 Hz. The next frequency is around 434 Hz. As you can see, the computed natural frequencies closely match the analytical results, confirming the accuracy of the simulation. Modeling has been completed. Now let's check what happens if we use fixed support instead of the current boundary conditions. First, I'll select the three boundary conditions defined earlier and suppress them. Then I'll right-click on Static Structural and choose Fixed Support. I'll select All Edges and hit Apply. Finally, I'll solve the model again. The solution is complete. Now, let's check the membrane stress. As you can see, there is no stress on the membrane because the fixed support overrides the line pressure. Next, I'll solve the modal analysis to examine the natural frequencies. The solution is complete. Let's check the results. As you can see, the natural frequency values have significantly decreased because there is no stretching in the membrane. This concludes the tutorial. Thank you for watching.